Hey, what's up, guys? Sneeze on You here. We're gonna be playing this conquest map as Fenrir. So this is my second time playing on this map. I played as Fenrir earlier. It was actually the game before this, and Anubis left as soon as the game started, so we were down 4v5, you know, and my team just kept wanting to play. We ended up playing for 40 minutes against this team, and we did pretty good, but it just got annoying really quick, you know, because they had an AO, they had a Zeus, and all they did was just lightning bolts and tornadoes, and at the end of the game, we had a commanding, like, KD than them.
Minions have spawned.
I think Zeus is gonna be mid. He should reach level 2 right here. So I'll be able to put it into my 1.
Be careful.
Awesome. So let's go to the side harpies. And get those side harpies. Those side harpies. So this map looks really nice, really, really nice. I don't know about the right side, but the left side has like a coastline. It looks pretty cool.
Enemy missing left.
And now we're gonna go left. Left lane. Left lane. We're gonna get this gold right here. Can't put anything into there. But we are going to get creeping curse. And we're gonna return. Main thing I wanna do is I wanna be close to the same rank as everyone else.
Has been slain. First blood.
Like one, you can die.
That's
I grab this
your
speed
middle
buff.
Tower is under attack. An enemy has left the game.
Okay, the enemy team just got a DC. Got the healing. We have speed now.
An enemy has been slain.
Okay, so I think I'm going up against the Fenrir. Is their jungle? Where's their Zeus?
Your middle tower is under attack. An enemy has returned.
Oh.
middle.
Grab this gold down here. Reason for all this movement is so I can get the XP and gold.
Your middle tower is under attack.
There's nothing worse than having your jungler fall behind. When I fall behind, that's pretty much it. Fall behind, I'm useless. When I gank, the ganks are, it feels like a feather's hitting you. I need the XP, I need the gold so I can buy the proper items.
Your middle tower is under attack.
Game I was jungling and then kept making this noise, you know.
Enemy missing right.
Can't finish that off yet.
An ally has been slain. An enemy has been slain. An ally has been slain.
I am gonna go with the Heartseeker in this build. Good job. I'm gonna help out left lane. We might even be able to get a kill. Oh man, the red's running out.
Enemy missing middle.
So we don't have our red buff.
Enemy missing left. Enemy missing middle.
Mini-map. She has to look at the mini-map. Frustrating, you know, we shouldn't have died there. So, Fenrir is level 9 now, 3 kills. Who did he kill?
Slain.
He killed me.
An enemy has been slain. Double kill.
So Fenrir is getting killed.
Your right tower is under attack. Enemy
I could have avoided his, okay, here we go.
Enemy missing middle! Be careful, left! You have slain an enemy! Perfect! You have been slain.
You can see how this is frustrating. This is the life of a jungler, you know. Like I was saying, you know, I could have completely avoided Zeus's ultimate right there. Okay, so we are gonna go Heartseeker, and we're gonna get a lot of health potions. Like I said, when I hit my ultimate and turned into that big dog, I had the option of going wherever I wanted with on her right in my mouth. Enemy tower. Oh wow, that. Oh man. So I could have went left, I could have went right, but I decided to stay in Zeus's ultimate. We're gonna get this red, and we're gonna get that mid tower. Help up that mid tower.
Okay, enemies so incoming left. I'll get right. Okay, ultimate is ready. Slay an enemy.
My path ends.
So the reason I'm picking on Guan Yu is because I know he's soloing against Aphrodite. Aphrodite's not that powerful, and she can be that powerful, but you have to be like really good at Aphrodite for her to be like OP. But what I'm getting at is I know he's gonna be going magical defense.
Your left tower is under attack. An enemy has been slain. An ally has been slain. An enemy has been slain.
So Zeus probably said,
"Ultimate is ready." Okay. Thanks.
Walker. And we'll help out here.
An ally has been slain. Sorry.
I honestly didn't think Fenrir was gonna go after him. But I didn't even see it.
Your fight has destroyed a middle enemy tower.
So we're level 13. We're gonna pick one right now.
An enemy has been slain. Again!
That was a good game. Towards the end, we started getting our kills. It's too bad we couldn't finish off the Heartseeker. We did end with 2,600 gold. But let's see the stats. One of the day for me. So as a team, we went 18, 10, and 27. 18 kills, 10 deaths, 27 assists. Aphrodite did a good job, you know, soul wing against, I think it was a Guan Yu and a, I'm not too sure who the second god was. Who was it? Agni was mid. I think it was on her, and then on her rotated. But Aphrodite did a great job, you know. Solo lane's very hard, 1v2, you know. Eventually they put one and one together and were like, okay, why are we gonna divide this coin and XP when one of us should just stay and, you know, the other one rotate. Myself, Fenrir, you know, I did 6-2. Oh, the other Fenrir went 7-2, but only had 2 assists. I have 3 assists, so. Zeus went 5-2, 4 assists. Guan Yu went 2-4. But he was mainly tanking. Looks like he was going for a little bit of magical penetration and some magical power. So he had 50 magical power. And then he was going to go physical defense. Maybe he was scared of the Fenrir and the Onher. And 4, 5-2. Good job. It looked like he finished off his Jotun's Wrath. It's mainly known for its passive, you know, not known for its physical power. The physical power is just a bonus. The passive is your ability cooldowns are reduced by 25%. So let's take a look at, did I look at the gold? Gold differential. We were only up by like 6,000, you know, so not too sure why, you know. People look at the KD, you know, they look at the kill death ratio and they're like, okay, the game's over, you know. But when you're looking at gold, you know, you once all the items are filled, you know, you have all 6 of your items, it's anybody's game, you know. Then gold doesn't become an issue. What becomes an issue is strategy. Who can get the fire giant and counterattack? Who can get the gold fury to get, you know, more whatever? So, player damage. Thor did the most player damage on our team. On the opposing team, their armor did the most player damage. Creep damage, yeah, we own that category. We definitely own that category. 37,000. Which is really good for 18.5 minutes. Healing wise, I want to see Aphrodite. Guan Yu, he didn't put any ranks or he didn't help his team whatsoever. You know, Fenrir is not he doesn't specialize in player healing. But look at that, you know, he's right there with Guan Yu, who specializes in helping his team out and healing with his one ability. So Aphrodite on our team did 5,700, which is good. So all in all, we had a good team, you know, we all played good, good communication. If you had fun, let me know. Leave a like. Thank you very much for checking out the channel. I'll see you guys next time.